My people of YouTube, welcome back for some more League of Legends content. We'll be watching the documentary series for Faker called Hall of Legends Faker. We watched the World's Anthem, and a lot of you guys recommended me to watch this documentary. I want to know who Faker is as a person, as a player, and why you guys regard him so much as the GOAT. Me being a person who's not really familiar with the esports scene of League of Legends or the game in general, because I never played League of Legends myself. And like, you know, I want to say, like, I feel like this is a good introductory time to get into and to know Faker as a person, as a player, of how good he is. I mean, it's kind of going to be hard for me to say because I don't know how to play the game. So, like, I don't know, if there's games, like, if there's clips of the games and shit, I won't really know how to read it because I don't know how to play League of Legends. So, like, yeah, so bear with me. Feel free to explain those plays in the comment section. I'll be happy to read them. I'll be happy to read them all. But other than that, we'll also be watching the World's Opening Ceremony as well, as a bunch of you guys wanted me to watch as well to react to. Besides, you know, the World's Anthems, we're going to watch the opening ceremonies. So make sure you like and subscribe and stay tuned for that. We'll probably watch it next week. But other than that, sit back and relax. Let's get right to this documentary.
전설이 되기 위해 필요한 건
Damn, what a fucking room, man. Throne. The Unkillable Demon King is a crazy ass name, man. That shot. It's like a here, damn, y'all just like damn. Not Mercedes Benz. It's like it's only been 30 seconds, bro. And it's like he, the setting of the room, like him on a fucking line, basically on the throne or the chair, like fancy, like, you know, like damn, it's like. It emits an aura, like, just, like, awesomeness, and, you know, like, damn. It's like, he's him.
Master, 숙면도죠. 전설의 전장의 다섯 개의 기동 중 하나입니다.
Mastery.
게임을 얼마나 잘 하느냐를 말하는 거죠. 자, 페이커의 이력서 한번 볼까요?
Oh, shit.
LCK 10회 우승, MSI 2회 우승, 그리고 월드 무료 4회
우승. World champion?
사실, 페이커는 떡잎부터 달랐죠.
Hold on. That's crazy, bro. Born different. I think somebody says a five-time. I think someone said he's five-time world champion now. I don't know. I think he won this year. Or won somebody said. But that's still fucking impressive.
He's built different. 게임을 좋아했던 페이커는 정말 엄청난 속도로 롤이라는 게임을 마스터해버렸죠.
네, 이제 프로하기 전에 제가 랭크 게임은 좀 무서워가지고 많이 안 돌렸는데.
Damn.
일반 게임을 많이 하다가 게임이 좀 안 잡히더라고요. 그때부터 좀 랭크 게임을 하기 시작했습니다.
Maybe in a gamer, I know that feeling. Damn, man, A16 top ranked player in Korea. SK Telecom.
The hype here in Korea.
Team one.
This SK Telecom team is immense.
아, 페이커 선수가 데뷔 전이 그 앰비션 선수와 붙었었는데 그때 앰비션 선수가 한국 3대 미드였거든요. 근데 그때도 제가 해설을 했었거든요. 그 기억이 지금 생생하네요.
So good to keep up. I was curious to see how well it happened.
Damn, I wish I played League Zero. So I know what's happening.
Whoa, ambition.
We got a kill.
Just executes ambition in that mid lane.
Ankle on top three.
미디였으면 평범한 미디였으면 그렇게 빛나지 않았었는데 앰비션을 뚫어버렸으니. 앰비션 선수가 그때 진화하는 그 타이밍이 있었는데 그 진화를 그걸 활용하겠다는 생각을 했던 거잖아요. 페이커 선수가 실행하는 건 다른 내용이었는데 그 자신감 자체가 굉장히 좀 대단해서 많은 분들께서 충격을 받았던 장면이었어요. 이 장면은요.
지금도 이제 그 분노가 아직도 기억에 날 정도로
Anger is crazy.
되게 인상 깊었던 그런 게임이었던 것 같고요. 아 그리고 제가 늘 하는 이야기인데 되게 농담이라고 사람들이 생각을 하더라고요. 페이커 선수가 이제 뭐 3천 킬을 하든 4천 킬을 하든 5천 킬을 하든
3,000, 4,000, 5,000
기억도 잘 못할 겁니다. 하지만
But I remember his kill.
첫 킬은 기억을 하죠. 네, 접니다. 나를 첫 번째로 킬해줘서 고맙다, 다녀가.
That's crazy.
이름 한번 불러다오.
But it's like that is crazy. They, you know, like what was it? They regard ambition as like one of the top three mid laners in the time. And it's like, you know, what is he? He's a rookie here. Faker was rookie and for his first kill, like, you know, like somebody regarded as the best. It's like, damn, like, that's, you know, like, you know, yeah. But at the same time, it's like when years pass, like, you know, as years pass and pass, and you know, you see the person the Faker develops to, like, it's kind of like an honor, like, you know, it's kind of like an accolade in itself now. Like, you know, I got killed by one of the greatest now, like, you know, it's kind of crazy, but it's funny.
또 이렇게 시간이 많이 흘러가지고 옛날에 있던
일을 yeah, it becomes funny. It becomes funny shit.
재밌게 말씀해 주시니까 저도 기분이 좋은 것 같습니다.
대 MB선을 상대로 이렇게 강렬한 데뷔전을 치른 페이커는 정말 정말 무서운 속도로 앞으로 나아갔습니다.
Well, Baker, oh, he gets a charm on Nemata, and he lights him out. Baker, they're not done yet. Impact has to dash away. Baker with the chase. He's going to go in and assassinate Elise. These are some of the most impressive...
I've ever played.
I'm like, even though I only have a mat on the floor, I think...
I don't know what's happening.
Maybe in trouble here, Deathmark. Tries to clean it up for Ryu. Oh, look at the cleanse. Look at the moves. Baker, what was that?
Damn.
There's just no way
he's still fucking alive.
You know, every you know iota of what just happened in front of me when I was casting that.
What the fuck happened?
He actually won that duel.
And that play, that game, is what put Faker and to a large part Korean League of Legends on the map.
Look at the moves, Faker. What was that?
Honest damn. 절벽사인데 부장님, 페이커 선수 잘했다고 생각을 하고 있습니다.
I was, he's the one that got murked. Champion Summer.
We gotta introduce you guys to Faker if you haven't seen him already. He might be just the best mid laner in the world.
Keep that farm going on. Reginald putting some pressure down, but Faker actually turning him down a lot of damage. Reginald goes aggressive, pushes the ultimate. Oh. Gotta get caught out. Faker gets him down.
There's so much information on the screen, bro. Faker, I don't think I can play League of Legends.
Mid, and they're into something new. Or I'll do fine and still learn something new.
Faker just takes lanes that might not be as one-sided as people think, and he just dominates them.
We have to consider they've found
oh, no. Once again!
Oh, no, damn, but like literally, it looks like he's just... After the other, the they're just swooping in!
Inhibitor turn at 12 minutes!
Cool was like, Faker-senpai, please no stop. And Faker was like, I'm not human. Like, I'm a robot programmed to play
that's crazy.
Joe Faker-nama.
Yeah, Killable DBK is a crazy ass nickname.
이만큼 성공적이고 또 인상적인 데뷔 연도를 보낸 루키.
And he's a rookie this time. And he's a rookie.
이때 엄청 기분 좋았죠. 지금 다시 생각해 보면 아 얘가 게임을 진짜 잘 알았구나. 그가 한 5, 6년은 더 앞섰구나라는 생각 많이 했었어요.
그러면 팀을.
Master이란 단어는 놀랍게도 현재뿐이 아닌 11년 전에 페이커에게도 참 어울린다는 거죠. 2013년 그렇게 페이커의 시대가 시작됩니다.
The Faker era began is crazy. 2013.
Creativity to me in League of Legends is using tools that other players are not using to defeat what is currently the most popular and meta strategies.
Damn.
So Faker's played 83 unique champions, more Damn. Than any other mid laner in pro play. This man plays basically everything.
And 83 characters?
The champs who will just not be viable mid laners, he's played most of any conceivable mid laner period. And the fact that he's often been first to do it, to be the one to be like, this is what we're playing now, and you're all going to keep up with me, is really impressive.
That's crazy. It sounds like he got so good at mastering all like 83. Well, I don't know how many characters I saw, but it's like 83 characters. And to the fact that he mastered them so perfectly, he's able to, like, I don't want to say like he's the one that creates the meta. Like you're gonna follow me now. What I do is what I'm gonna do now. That's some crazy ass influence though. But like, it sounds like, you know, he's able to, like, it sounds like he's able to be like flexible with it too, because he like, you know, so many characters that, like, you know. He sounds like he's able to be very flexible with it.
Or if it's going to be a mid Aurelia. You look at Gorilla on your screen right now. He looks a bit confused.
상대 팀 입장에서는 이제 그때 당시에 준비하는 데 있어서
coach?
이런 표현을 해도 될지 모르겠지만 그냥 되게 답이 없었을 것 같다.
We know 83 characters could fucking mix it up a lot.
I don't know which one.
He didn't follow meta either.
I would suspect this is a mid Aurelia.
이디레이다.
처음인데.
Comes in, there's a four-man pulverize. Kuro knocked back into the play, and Faker takes him out onto, well, Bang actually gets a kill in the prey. Faker, oh, double. The double kill!
I don't think I can play League.
나올 수가 없는 픽이었는데 그러다 보니까 그렇게 좀
and he made it work.
당황했던 것 같아요. 그 당시에는 그런 픽들이 좀 평상시에 좀 많이 떠올랐던 것 같아요.
그만
게임에 대해서 너무 열정적이고 뭐 밥 먹을 때도 게임 얘기하고 저희 쉬는 날에도
놀러 가자 했을 때 뭐 게임 하는 경우도 굉장히 많았었고.
Faker can play anything. Wow, it's
Hey gang, that grind makes you the best.
That's got to be Faker playing the Master Yi. Here comes Ambition. They're going to turn onto him though. Faker gets the damage. Oh, not quite enough because of the position reversal. No, he does get enough.
He teleports.
Double kill. Shy looks like he's going to be able to get
Damn.
Under turrets. Uh-oh. Wolf coming in. Double six. They get the flash from Nagne. Faker comes in. He's got
Damn. Kill.
At this time in history, this was truly Faker God status. Just styling on people, picking these champions that no one else played.
That's crazy.
Champion summer for his team, SK
That's
Telecom.
Crazy.
3-0 in the spring season, 3-0 in the summer season.
That's
this
crazy.
Is the year of SKT.
사실 그때는 제 페이커 선수가 하는 게 메타가
That's what it sounds like. Like, yo, you gotta follow me. I'm the meta.
못하는 플레이를 해내거나 또 그런 상황이 아닌데 이런 상황을 만들어내는 그 선수들이 조금 되게 창의력이 좋다.
I like that a lot, though.
그렇게 말씀드릴 수 있을 것 같아요.
I fuck with the heavy though. Hold on, I'm always gonna roll on the stage. he pulled it off nicely. 1v2? You know how demoralizing that has to be, bro?
Just going into the river brush, but it's gonna be Kuro getting dropped immediately. How did he even think he could take that fight?
He's probably the
most great player. The Tobis are fire.
There are multiple plays throughout Faker's career where you probably wouldn't be able to practice it, and it wouldn't surprise me if he sat there and told you that's the first time I've ever done that.
That's crazy. That's a flex.
They do see Faker, and the cocoon's not gonna land though, so can they get anything else? The flash chase, it's Smeb onto his face, looking for a little bit more, and he's not gonna go down. Faker with just the ghost gets away.
He didn't fucking die. Damn.
이제 항상 T1이었잖아요. T1은 또 항상 이제 강팀이었었고.
He stayed in the same team his whole career?
끝까지 방심할 수가 없었습니다.
He's an innovator. Seeing the kind of things he can do with the tools that we put in the game, it makes us happy to be like, oh, wow, this guy can do that? Okay, that's cool.
That's wild.
Please join me in welcoming your finalists for the
2016
Worlds
Grand Finals.
World
Championship. Was that him? It's like, what's going on? It's like, I'm trying to see what's going on.
그 당시에 정글러를 가장 잘 쓰는 미드가 페이커 선수가 아니었을까? 뱅기 선수를 페이커의 그림자라고 그냥 표현을 많이 했었거든요. 그만큼 그냥 뭐만 하면은 뒤에 있는 것 같고 실제로 한번 공격적으로 들어가 보면 항상 뱅기 선수가 있었고.
게임을 하면서 정말. 이 페이커 선수를 잡기도 되게 힘들고
Long time rival?
무난하게 가면은 또 페이커 선수가 캐리를 할 것만 같고 그런 게 좀 되게 많이 무서웠고 정말 벽같이 느껴졌습니다.
Damn. If
you make one mistake, then they will take that mistake and find a way to take the game away from you.
That's some crazy shit, bro. One mistake it causes the whole game is wild. Their trophies are fucking elite though. Damn, look how massive this shit. Cool. It was designed, man.
This era of Faker felt truly unstoppable.
Offer this a butt. That's fire. Hold on. Like, honestly, that's honestly a pretty fucking awesome segment. The fact that you're able, like, He mastered 83 fucking characters to the point where, like, he popped, during tournaments, he literally just used whatever the fuck he wants. Like, my man knew the game that good that he popped whatever character he wanted in there, and he made it work. He made it work, like, I mean, I never played this type of games. I'm a Call of Duty person. I know the game is trash, don't worry about it, bro. But it's like, you know, like, meta for us is different. I don't want to talk about it, because, like, because meta and Call of Duty doesn't really have any that much flexibilities, or there's the meta weapons, that's pretty much it. But like, it sounds like League of Legends meta is not, it doesn't, like, meta is always mean like 100% meta, like, you know, it sounds like you can actually overcome metas easily, well, if you know how to play other characters and, you know, do other strats and stuff. And the fact that Faker just did it on the big stage with no problem is fucking crazy. That's a huge, you know how it must feel to be the enemy team. So I'm like, oh, you're gonna play him? Like, what the fuck? Like, you know, like, you're gonna play him? Like, hello? Like, but it's like, you know, like in the hands of a good player like Faker, like, you know, he'll make that shit work, and it looks like it paid off really well.
World 2015, 2016. 로봇이다라는 말을 어떤 의미인지 알 것 같거든요. 저는 오히려 프로 게이머를 했던 사람으로서 그거 되게 칭찬에 가깝다고 생각을 하는데.
We call the robots crazy too.
제가 옆에서 본 상영이는 일단 절대 그런 건 아니에요.
Not as a person.
이제 SKT가 당시에 월즈를 계속 우승을 했어요.
I like. I took a moment to say like I love their jacket like. Like I'm a fan of red and black and red white, and I just love it. Like damn, it's like it's, it pops. Like even with the even like they got the twist, like their sponsorship, it's not over the top. But like you know, like honestly, like, that shit is kind of clean. Like without the sponsorship, just like the SK Telecom T1 shit, their logo is there. That's a fire. That's clean.
이제 SKT가 당시에 월즈를 계속 우승을 했어요. 그래서 어떻게 보면 이 팀이 월즈를 우승하는 거 좀 당연하다라고 느껴질 만큼 정말 압도적인 포스를 보여주고 있었는데요. 그 당시에 시청을 시작한 입장으로서는 너무 당연한 느낌으로 이 팀이 또 해주겠지.
Nah, don't jinx it.
I came halfway through 2017, which was, you know, SKT continuing to be dominant, but you know, some upstart teams making their way through. And right at the end of my very first year, that was when Faker's downfall started.
Oh shit. This is fucking awesome. Like, you know, like he's reimagining that moment. Some dope, ass. Ooh.
그때 딱하게 보였습니다. 그래서 앞으로 나아갔습니다.
Damn. Oh shit. They 3-0'd them. Damn, going into a tournament where y'all were the favorites to win.
근데 상영이가 우는 모습을 본 거는
That has to be feel though.
처음이었던 것 같긴 해요. 근데 저 때 제가 바로 옆에 있었는데 그냥 우는 게 아니었어요. 진짜 거의 약간 목 놓아 운다고 해야 되나? 같은 팀 동료가 그렇게 슬퍼하는 모습을 또 보니까 마음이 많이 안 좋았죠.
네. Yeah, I mean, it's probably never easy losing the big stage like that.
저도 울었죠.
His father.
자식이 오는데 뭐 안 울은 거 같겠어요.
이때 당시 정말 선수들이 어떻게 보면은
can you take a moment to appreciate the arena? Holy shit. The venue is fucking insane. Damn.
그때 당시에 이제 정말 선수들이 어떻게
Look at the venue. Like the only sports I watch is Call of Duty, but like even that, like damn, this shit is like League of Legends is like what? It's like more like more international global than Call of Duty. Like yeah, it's like but damn, that's like damn, this shit is nice. like jumping into this role, like damn, the venue is crazy.
계속 강행군을 해왔었고 제 개인적인 생각으로는 너무 힘들었을 거라고 저는 생각해요. 왜냐면은 저도 너무 힘들었었고요. 그때 당시에 이제 우리 T1의 기대치는 기본이 우승이었었고 예를 들어 또 승리를 했다 하더라도
That's a lot of weight.
네. 그런 얘기가 나오던 팀이어서
We expected to be like the winners, 100% winners.
That's a lot of pressure. 힘들었을 거라고 생각해요.
That's a lot of pressure. Cuz like once you crash and lose it's like poof, it's deep. Cause everybody's high expectations. That's such a fucking fire jersey. Oh my god.
그 준 우승하고 나서 한 2, 3년 상혁이가 좀 많이 좀 힘들어했던 걸로 저는 기억을 하고 있습니다.
And everyone at the Nexon Arena and you in the chat were there when the dream died for SK Telecom T1 and the Korea curse when it comes to SKT making it to a domestic world championship shit. Does extend from 2014 to 2018.
18년도 때는 아마 그때 좀 멤버들도 많이 나가고 또 바뀌고 해가지고 또
새로운 멤버들이랑 같이 하게 됐는데 그때 이제 좀
chemistry
또 팀적으로 되게 안 좋았고 뭔가 계속해서 노력을 해도 뭔가 이기가 너무 어렵다 이렇게 생각을 많이 했어가지고 되게 어떻게 해야 될지 좀 답답하고 그런 연도였던 것 같아요. BL has never won before, but that will change
today. The crownless are finally king. At a world championship too?
The team won Dynasty. Like was probably for the first time, one of the only times really out of the picture. They just weren't the first team that you brought up. They weren't the first team that you talked about.
This is it. The greatest team in the history of League of Legends taken down by the greatest team Europe has ever produced.
He was just the mid laner, the guy to beat. I also had been watching him for so many years, so to come out on top there, I mean, we were just overjoyed.
Yeah. Like everybody coming up to T1.
To the World Championship of 2020. T1, we will not be seeing them at Worlds.
They didn't make it to Worlds.
저가는 해라는 평가가 들리기도 했고요.
That's fucked
up. 에이징 커브, 단순 슬럼프가 아니다.
So we're looking at these new players, and Chovy comes in with his 150 KDA, and then Showmaker comes through with all of his ridiculous plays.
You tell him.
Old legacies, goodbye, Faker.
Hey, that has to be like that. That's crazy.
Hello, Dom Juan and Showmaker.
Like it, like I mean, I watch sports, so like you know, I kind of get this shit too. Like I kind of get with sports, like even like with age comes, like you know, like people like new talent have come. New talent coming that will beat you, and then people talk about is it are your days over? You know, are you that's it, bro? Like you're washed, you're done. You know, that happens a lot, bro. That happened to my Spurs. Once Tim Duncan retired, it was never the same. But you know, it happens. It happens a lot of sports. Like you know, the legends. You know, eventually their days come up and shit. Like you know, it's over. People start questioning, like are they still good? Can they still perform? All that pressure, and like even probably for Faker too. All that pressure, all those social media people talking shit, everything will probably get into your head, and like, it's just like it's fucked up. But that's how the thing is competitive.
이제 모든 프로 게이머들의 우상이 되시는 분인데 이제 그런 프로 게이머랑 제가 비교되는 것 자체가 되게 영광이었고
거기서 경기가 다 끝나고 이제 저한테 먼저 다가와서 수고하셨습니다. 네, 이런 얘기를 했던 게 기억에 남는데 이 부분은 뭐라고 좀 표현할 수 없는 부분의 감정인 것 같아요. 네.
What's so odd?
Faker 선수는 되게 불편한 위치에 있어요. 게임만 잘하면 안 돼요. 게임도 잘해야 돼요. 팀도 이끌어야 되는데 상징성이 있어요. 흔들려서도 안 돼요.
That's a lot of pressure, though.
그걸 못해서도 안 돼요.
That's way too much pressure. Like, yes, be perfect all the time.
11년
But he's human.
이런데도 듣기만 해도 불편하잖아요.
Literally, bro, is like, it's crazy. It's a lot of pressure.
때는 저는 이제 좀 되게 자기 주장도 강했고 저의 자아도 되게 강했기 때문에 제가 했던 그런 경험들에 비춰서 좀 뭔가 다음 행동을 결정했다면 지금은 좀 더 그런 지난 저의 경험들을 좀 더 객관적으로 많이 바라보고 또 타인의 그런 관점도 많이 받아들이고
좀 수용하면서
더 많이 성숙해질 수 있었다고 생각합니다.
다른 기회를 만들어내고 또다시 우승하고 그런 것들이 인간으로서도 되게 대단한 일인 것 같아요.
That's big.
명예력이라고 하면 되게 뭔가 버티고 견뎌내는
그런
뜻이잖아요. 저는 사실 그것보다는 그냥 되게 힘든 일이나 역경이 있을 때 그거를 이겨내려고 하는 것보다 잘 받아들이고
Learn.
그 속에서 배울 점들을 배우고
Learn.
파도 타듯이 잘 이겨내는 게 중요한 것 같습니다.
Damn. That's good though. It keep him down. You learn from it.
상혁이 형이 11년 동안 많은 멤버들과 시간을 보내왔었는데
Guarantee, mate.
저희 제우페국회가 최고 아닐까요?
Those jerseys are so clean.
제우스가 합류하면서 제우스 오너, 페이커, 구마요시, 캐리어
Sicario.
일명 제우페국회가 드디어 완성됩니다. 제우페국회 그리고 그들이 바로 일을 냅니다. 전승 우승.
This team is working like a well-oiled machine. 18-0
got the team.
For the first time in the LCK, unprecedented from this T1 roster. T1 are your spring 2022 victors.
I would say the number one thing Faker probably got from all these rookies joining is an energy boost. You know, when you're sitting there and you have these bubbly personalities, maybe it fueled him a bit. Maybe it gave him a second win.
I mean, you're 18-0 too. That shit is like promising.
차이가 좀 근데 상혁이가 또 형으로서 또 해야 될 일을 자기 스스로가 좀 알지 않았나 그런 생각이 들어요.
보통 좀 긴장을 하고 있으면은 상혁이 형이 그런 말들을 좀 해주는 거
같거든요.
뭐 긴장하지 마라. 어차피 뭐 똑같은 경기다 그냥 뭐 스크림처럼만 하자. 상혁이 형이 하는 말이라서 좀 더 도움이 되고 의미가 되는 경우가 있었던 것 같습니다.
This is him telling me, yo. Even the black, old black dolly is sick.
One more time, San Francisco. It's DRX and T1.
No Leeson arounds means no attempt at a smite steal.
Oh, back the Baron, still at 3,000 HP. Smite, definitely gonna get
it. It's so much, y'all. I don't think I can play League, bro. It's like so. I mean. Like, it'll probably get like, easier, like, you know, like, if you actually play the game, you know what the fuck is happening, but, like, I'm just looking at it, like, damn, there's a lot of information on the screen, like, what the fuck is going on? Like, I mean, it might also be Codcaster view, because, I mean, when you Codcast, there is a lot of information, but it's, like, not Codcast, but, you know, you're a caster. Oh, my God, I got to get this out of my mind. But when you're a caster, there's a lot of information on your screen, it's, like, you know, so you know what's happening, but, like, damn, it's, like, even in the action, like, I'm trying to see where the fuck is Faker, where's Faker, what's happening? Like, damn.
DRX are taking us to game five.
Too tired. We lost. Is this the fucking... What is this? What's the song? What was the name of the song? Is it Gods?
민석이 오는 거 보고 상혁이 생각을 먼저 했어요. 지금 17년도에 상혁이 모습하고 거의 똑같아가지고.
네.
아, 절실했구나. 절실했었구나 하는 거야.
저희는... 다 그때 결승을 처음 간 멤버들이었는데 상혁이 형은 본인 우승도 해봤고 결승도 좀 많이 가봤어서 다른 멤버들의 아쉬움이 좀 더 할 수 있지 않을까? 라는 심정으로 다른 멤버들을 먼저 확인했던 것 같습니다.
그냥 이제 좀 다른 선수들이 좀 괜찮은지 좀
봤던 것 같고 that big brother
어쨌든 결승전에서 지는 거는 되게 많이 아쉬운 거니까
so that was immature though.
그렇긴 한데 저는 이제 어쨌든
as that mindset
또 다음 내년도 있고 그런 생각을 많이 했어가지고 좀 다른 선수들 챙기려고 했던 것 같습니다.
I give him hella fucking props for that. I give him hella props for that.
2023년도 서머 때부터 뭔가 되게 팔 쪽이 저리고 좀 무감각한 게 있어가지고 그래서 좀 이제 지켜보면서 경기를 했는데 점점 좀 악화가 되니까 결국에는 이제 월드를 위해서 저는 좀 휴식을 팀이랑 상의해서 결정했던 것 같고요.
단 한 명 페이커가 없는 건데.
They subbed? You guys have subs
too? 계속된 선수 생활로 인한 그 무리한 손목 사용으로 잠시 치료를 받고 있을 뿐인데
That's crazy, bro.
이렇게까지 팀이 달라지나? T1이 아니었습니다.
That's you know he's a I mean Faker he's a big ass piece.
할 수 있는 거는 뭐 부상에 대해서 막 그렇게 안 좋게 생각하는 것보다는 좀 좋게 생각하려고 했고 저는 뭐 제가 복귀하면은 월드는 갈 수 있다 이런 생각이었고.
After 31 days of being out, Faker makes his return to the LCK. And Guma's also there.
상혁이 형이 돌아오고 난 뒤에 뭐.
오늘부터
이야기를 하면서 다 같이 웃었던 것 같습니다.
Just like that. Just like that. Damn, bro.
요새 이상혁 선수를 보면 굉장히 좀 형 같은 느낌이 많이 들거든요. 그래서 팀의 리더 역할 그리고 중심 역할을 하다 보니까 네, 개인의 성장에서도 그런 분위기가 아, 정말 제가 봐도 좀 형 같다 이런 분위기가 많이 느껴지는 것 같습니다.
또 이렇게 like 힘든 시기가 있었기 때문에 또 우리가 더 성장할 수 있었지 않았을까 그렇게 좀 감사하게 생각했던 것 같아요.
That man took his first L, learned from it. And he matured as a person too. I fucking love you. What was the song?
Back in 2013 is really where we witnessed the beginning of the legacy that Faker was about to build, even though we did not know that it was unfolding right before our eyes. By the time we arrived in 2023, Faker has already become an absolute legend, an icon. He's proven anything and everything.
He's been competing for a minute too, damn, bro.
There was that lingering question if he was ever going to win a world championship again. And the biggest chance offered itself up. The world championship was being held in South Korea, something Faker had never been able to qualify before. This time, he made it.
I think there was so much pressure on him to be able to succeed and on the Korean teams to be able to succeed this year. JDG on their way to the Golden Road, they had one spring, they had one MSI, they had one summer, and they were coming into Worlds as the heavy
That's
favorites.
That's a tough shot, yeah.
T1 also lost to both LPL representatives at MSI. They lost to Gen G in summer. People just didn't think they could do it. But lo and behold, when quarterfinals came around, all of a sudden, T1 is the lone representative alive from the LCK.
Somebody explained to me. Well, I think LCK is like the Korean, the Korean division. I think LCS is European. Or LEC, I don't want to, I think one of those is European, one is American or North America. Fuck. Somebody wrote a paragraph about it in the fun comment section. I apologize, I forgot, but.
Task ahead of them is.
That's the case, the only Korean team in the hometown, is, well, not hometown, but like home, not hometown, man.
Damn it. Today. And if you get through that, well, then you get to play JDG, so it's just insane.
뭐 쉽지는 않을 거다라고 생각을 했고, 그래도 저희가 연습 되게 열심히 하고, 이제 점점 외주를 통해서 저희가 경기력이 성장하는 게 많이 보였기 때문에 할 수 있겠다 이렇게 생각했던 것
같습니다.
There's so much on the screen. I need a map. They're just swarming.
Faker stays standing. T1 stays standing.
They just fucking swarmed in there.
The LCK burns bright as they head to the semifinals.
Even their logo is tough.
For the next 2 minutes and 20 seconds, it's JDG who are favored. Not quite enough members in the mid lane. T1 just need to weather the storm.
네, 딱 각이 보였습니다. 그래서 앞으로 나아갔습니다.
Is that what he said earlier in the fucking video? Isn't that what Ruler said earlier in the video? I saw that angle. What? That feels like such a top, bro. Hold on. He said with a smirky face too. Hello. It's like, you know, how should I put it? It's like, you know, like he's online against it. Like, I saw that angle. Like, you know, like, just to taunt him too, because I'm pretty sure Ruler said the same shit earlier in the video. Damn, bro. And on him too. Damn, we got Lawrence. What the fuck? There's so much happy on screen.
We get goosebumps watching League of Legends plays. I think Fake is responsible for like.
I wish I knew what's happening on screen. I wish I knew what's happening on screen. I see red and blue and health going down. Grand finals. Damn, yo, these arenas, bro. I can't wait to watch the world opening ceremonies. Only four? One. Oh, your team pulled up. God damn. And they won it.
The CSKT legacy has been reignited.
shut down the haters. Shut down all the haters. No doubt. I respect it. Why am I getting goosebumps like I play League of Legends? Like I know what's going on, bro. Like I'm a fan. Is it the way they do it? Like the way they direct it? Like the cinematography shit? Like the way that this video is like... They're so nice. Yeah, yo, whoever designs that trophies, bro, give him a prize, bro.
중국의 모 매체는 봉준호, BTS, 김연아, 손흥민 그리고 페이커를 5대 국보라고 했고,
아, 미국의 National Treasures 모
스포츠 매체에서는 손흥민, BTS, 봉준호 그리고 페이커를 엘리트 4라고 했습니다. 그는 이미 어떤 종목, 어떤 스포츠란 장르에 머무르는
You know, it's called one of the five Korean national treasures. Wow.
And looking back,
yeah, shit is crazy.
League of Legends esports and Faker, they needed each other in a way. You know, there was a platform given by League of Legends, going professional and having all these leagues, and then there was one person who stood up and said, "I will
that's
be
tough.
That icon for you."
That's tough. That pose. Damn, that's a tough ass.
Something isn't reading a book about a fictional character. They're looking up to an actual human being.
Idol.
That is the reason that so many people play, because of this single human
being.
Yeah,
that's like that.
He's just the final boss of League of Legends.
That's crazy.
Favorite选手是英雄联盟最高的山。Killable
Demon King.
以及最长的河，他拥有着像珠穆朗玛峰一般的荣耀，在荣耀方面可能其他选手难以企及。而我做英雄联盟解说时逾有年，蓦然回首，我发现 Faker
的职业生涯还要长。He's been playing for a minute. It looks like.
而且他一直没有停止前进。
Is that official? Is that official? That's clean. No, that's clean for like him crying.
一直没有停止前进。
That's clean. Nah, whoever shot this, bro? Dang, that's a clean shit. That's a clean transition.
바로 옆은 아니더라도 좀 뭔가 상혁이 형의 뒤에 있는 그런 선수가 되었으면 좋겠습니다.
오르막길 있으면 내리막길도 있고 그러니까 이제 그 내리막길이 있고 나서 다시 계속 열심히 포기하지 않고 연습하신 게
Facts, bro.
그게
제대로라고
생각합니다. 저도 이제 경력이 되게 오래됐는데 오래 하면서도 뭔가 오래 하면 할수록 힘든 부분이 더 많은 것 같다고 생각이 드는데 페이커 선수는 저보다 더 오래된 선수잖아요. 그런 부분에서
like
대단하다고 느끼고
so going.
언제든 이제
going.
노력하면은 정상자리에 yeah. 설 수 있구나라는 걸 되게 많이 생각했고 많이 자극 받았던 것 같습니다.
也对我们职业选手起了一个很好的榜样，这年坚持对我们这些老将，说实话也算一道激励。
Mình cũng thể tưởng tượng một ngày nào đó mà khi mà người ta nhắc đến Lê Minh Nguyệt, người ta không còn nhắc đến Faker nữa sẽ như nào.
Mình
nghĩ là những cái thứ mà mọi người có thể tưởng tượng và kiểu sẽ rất là khó hình dung ra được một ngày đó sẽ đến. Nó giống như kiểu một ngày mà mọi người không ai mong chờ đến vậy.
그냥 미스터 LOL이잖아요.
Mr. LOL, Mr. League of Legends.
그렇잖아요. So LOL 이렇게 해야 되나?
Sir, League of Legends is crazy. That's crazy.
Brandon and I, as PC gamers,
I mean, he's not crazy, but he has the accolades to back it up and everything.
Games that were truly sports that we love to watch.
He has everything to back it up.
People love to really compete with. The thought of being able to create something that would earn the fandom and sort of opportunity to be an esport was a true dream. And Faker is the face of the sport. He is the ultimate personification of the things that make League
Damn.
Great.
Everybody ready? Goats on notes. 한 단어로 얘기하자면 소나무라고 얘기할 수 있을 것 같아요. 좀 진부할 수 있지만 비가 와도 눈이 와도 시간이 가도 뭐 어떤 힘든 일이 있어도 늘 푸르다. 이게 상혁 선수 페이커.
Bro, these transitions, bro. Whoever shot and ended this video, bro.
I think that
applause to yeah, bro.
On this game, on this sport, it is unlike anything that esports. Broadly has ever seen. And so, you know, we are incredibly grateful for his contribution and what he has done and how he's carried this game to new heights. So congratulations, Faker, on this very deserved honor.
전설의 전당 첫 번째 헌액자 이상혁 선수 헌액 진심으로 축하합니다.
여기서 만족할 사람이 아니란 걸 또 알기 때문에 올해도 그리고 앞으로도 같이 화이팅 했으면 좋겠고.
전설의 전당 첫 헌액자라고 들었는데 이제
Hall of Legends. That sounds tough. Instead of Hall of Fame, but Hall of Legends sounds so much cooler.
이전에 이제 맨 처음에 이상형이 있었다. 좀 이렇게 되는 게.
But it's like, 부러... I mean,
네.
I mean, it's like, but like, I mean, I'm not familiar with the fucking players. So like, I don't know who, like, who's the, who's like, you know, like, who you put, who else would you put in the Hall of Legends there as well? Like, I'm not really familiar with the esports scene, so I don't know the players. Like, but like, you know how much of an honor has to be put, like, next to like one of the like, you know, being included with the GOAT, like, being like. Being the second inductee to the Hall of Legends, you know how awesome that accolade must feel, bro. That's a crazy ass achievement.
부럽네.
But being the first, bro, they.
더 있으면은 더 됐을라나?
일단 상혁이 전설의 전당에 처음으로 헌액된 거를 너무 축하하고 너무나도 당연한 일이라고 생각하지만
당연히 초대 헌액이 되어야 하는 선수라고 생각하고.
And he's still competing.
그리고 앞으로도. 정말 많은 또 전설들을 써내려갈 거라고 생각을 하고 이 자리가 정말 걸맞다고 생각을 해서 정말 축하한다는 얘기를 해주고 싶고 더 앞으로도 한 짧게
7, 8 years
7, 8년 정도만 더 해먹었으면 좋겠다는 얘기를 하고
싶습니다.
사혁이 형 진심으로 축하하고 이제 사실 뭐 초대로 이렇게 오르는 게 당연하다 생각하고 페이커라는 선수가 그래서 앞으로도 오랫동안 좋은 모습 보여주면서 팬분들에게 큰 기쁨을 선사하면서 활동했으면 좋겠고
상혁아 그동안 진짜 너무 멋있었고 앞으로도 멋있었으면 좋겠다. 전설의 전당 너무 축하한다. 다음에는 내가 할 수 있을까?
앞으로도 많은 분들께 좋은 영향력을 끼쳐준 만큼 우리 스스로도 행복하고 또 건강하고 그런 삶을 살았으면 좋겠습니다. 축하드립니다.
아들 아무튼 축하하고 또 이게 또 어깨가 또 무거운 일이 생겼네. 아무튼 첫 번째라는 거는 원래 어깨가 무거운 건데 또 너를 또 응원해 주는 여러 사람들이 있다는 걸 알고 더 열심히 뭐 해서 꼭 갚았으면 좋겠다는 생각이 드네. 아무튼 축하해.
전설의 전당에 이렇게 1회에 올라갈 수 있는 선수는 또 상혁이밖에 없다고 생각합니다. 근데 이렇게 또 없다고 표현할 정도로
나오는
그 정말 그 긴 기간 동안 얼마나 힘들었을까라는 또 생각이 드니까 한편으로는 정말 짠하기도 하고 하지만 그런 걸 다 극복해내고 견뎌내고 이렇게 해왔기 때문에 페이커라고 생각이 듭니다. 진심으로 다시 한번 축하합니다.
Damn. That's tough. That's tough.
이번에 전설의 전당 초대 헌액자가 된 기념으로 That's 많은 so 분들이 이렇게 축하의 말씀 주셨는데 정말 감사하고 감동적인 것 같고요.
I the fact that like, he seems like a very very humble ass person.
제가 이 자리에 또 오기까지 많은 팬분들
despite his accolades, you know, everybody called him the GOAT, being regardless the GOAT.
지지가 있었기 때문에 제가 이렇게 올 수 있었던 것 같아서 전설의 전당 헌액보다 많은 분들의 응원 그리고 감사가 저에게 더 가치 있는 것 같고요.
I fuck with the heavy.
앞으로도 저를 뛰어넘는 선수들이 많이 나와서 전설의 전당에 꽉 찼으면 좋겠고 앞으로도
That's clean, dude.
열심히 하겠습니다.
I fuck with heavy, even as a person. Yeah, kill it. Look at the jerseys. Their jerseys are so clean, bro. It's the colorway and their logo. That's all the trophies? Damn. Former temporary figures forever is a tough ass line.
전설이 되기
위해
필요한 건 무엇일까요?
Next world championship. He's coming for ya. The locker thumbs up. Damn, that was good. This is Finn. That's it. Hey, that's it. Damn, that was actually. That was actually pretty great. That was great. Like, damn, like that was honestly pretty fucking great. Like, shit, like as a player, like, you know, getting to know Faker as a person, as a player, I fucking heavy. Like, his story, like, from what we learned from this video, from what we got from the story, honestly pretty great. Cause like, first of all, I love the fact that like, I think he even mentioned that he had a strong ego, but even from that, like, he learned how to, like, you know, was it like, you know, go along with the wave, like, you know, like, he matured, became open-minded and stuff. Like, you know, he matured as a person as well. Cause like, you know, like some people like, and like, I'm gonna talk about sports because like, that could relate it to, because I watch sports, I don't watch League of Legends. As like, you know, like, some people regard the best, some of them have egos. Like, you know, when you start winning a lot, you have ego. Some people are like that, some people are assholes with egos. But it's like, Faker's a very like humble person. Like, he learned from like his loss. Like, he had a downfall like for a couple of years, but like, you know, for some people, like, those, that type of downfall, that type of pressure regarding the best, you know, is your time up? Are you gonna retire? You're gonna stop playing and stuff, like, you know. That type of pressure and those kind of shit goes into your head, and they will force you down. But it looks like, you know, it looks like Faker, like, you know, he learned from it, and he learned how to like improve himself, how to become better. He learned how to keep going and going. It didn't keep him down as a player, as a person. Obviously, you will have your hardships in the beginning of it, but then as time passes, you will learn, you will adapt, it'll make you stronger as a person, as a player itself. Exactly what it looked like with Faker, and like, that's how he matured as well mentally. And that was honestly awesome when they lost. I forgot the name of the team. When they lost, what was 2012? Was 2022? 2020? Was 2022? I think it was 2022, 2023. When they lost that year, when he lost with his new teammates, I think they were young. This was the first role. Like, he played the big brother role there too. Just like, you know, that just shows you the experience. Like, he's a veteran in basketball. Like, we use the veteran, the term veteran in the team, because like, you know, they're the veteran. They'll teach the newcomers how to deal with situations. They'll look out for you. They'll you know, just make sure, because he's been there. He's been in that type of position where he had the downfall to himself at his peak. Like, I mean, this is the first time, so like, you know, it hits, and he's able to, like, you know, I fucking heavy, because like, damn. Like it wasn't just a career that went near. It had a work, had his down, and then went straight back up. And like, the fact that he's the first inductee to the Hall of Legends, it's awesome, because he has the accolades to back it up. Everybody knows him, even his rivals. They know, like, yo, he's him. Like, you know, he has that respect from everybody. And it's like, damn, bro, like, that's crazy, bro. That's actually wild. But like, I wish like, I knew more about League of Legends, the actual game, and like, you know, the rivalry stuff, and like, more about the insights between regarding his rivalry, the plays that he pulled off. Because it sounds like from the casters, it sounded like, yo, some crazy shit. I don't know what was happening. Like, we never played the game, and I don't know what the fuck is happening on screen, but it sounds like the caster makes it sound like, yo, he's just some crazy shit. Like, damn, bro. Like, all I really see is his little name, like the little health bars and shit going down, him running, like, you know. And it's like, damn, bro. It sounds like some crazy ass plays he's making, bro. It's like, damn. And we regarded the best, bro. It's like, shit. He could back up the talk, but I like the fact that he's like, he seems like a very humble, like, and chill person, like, you know, like a very humble personality. Like, he doesn't like show off his wealth, his fucking, like, not his wealth, but like his reputation. Like, you know, he doesn't show it off. Like, I'm him. Like, you know, he's not obnoxious, he doesn't seem like the obnoxious type to show it off. Now, I respect it heavily. I respect his journey, even though it's like the first time I got to know him. Like, I respect the journey like tremendously, because he had his downfall. He even suffered, like, he had an injury, like, what was it with his arm? Like, he couldn't feel it. It started tingling, like. He even suffered an injury, and it's like, and like, during that time, I think T1 had a sub. I don't know who the sub was, but like, they had a sub and they were losing games. And as soon as Faker came back after his break, after his rehabilitation, he came back and they started winning. It's like, damn, bro, you know, that's how you know you're a big ass important player that plays a big part into your games. Like, damn, bro, like, he's that shit. But I fucking this shit heavy. Like, also big shout out to whoever filmed this, like, whoever's editing the filming. A phenomenally, bro, because like, damn, yeah, you have me hyped. You got me. I got goosebumps, like, and I'm not familiar with this shit. Like, bro, I'm new to this shit, and I was getting goosebumps. Like, damn, bro, like, shit, like, it's like, it's hard not to cheer for him now. Like, it's really hard not to cheer for him. Like, yeah, like, damn, this is actually pretty awesome. This is actually pretty fucking awesome. Like, I like this a lot. And like, it's a big, obviously, it's a huge tribute to him as well. It's awesome. I wonder if they're gonna get a ceremony now. Honestly, I can't wait to watch the opening ceremonies for Worlds, because their venues, like when we got to see some of the scenes, their venues for like the World stage is pretty fucking awesome. That looks awesome, but like, damn. This is awesome. This is like a great documentary. I fuck with it, damn. Damn, Faker's really the GOAT. Faker's really the GOAT. He cemented himself as the GOAT. Shit. it's not like basketball, but in basketball, people argue about, no, it's Jordan. No, it's LeBron. It's Kobe. Or like in Formula One, it's Lewis. It's a Senna. It's a Michael Schumacher. You know how the sports, but like, it's crazy how like, here, it's clearly Faker. It's only Faker. It's him. That's it. I mean, probably, there's probably conversations in the community, probably other players that you probably put up there. I don't know. You know, probably some people have those kind of arguments in the League of Legends community. But like, damn. So 100% solidify yourself as the first inductee, but as the GOAT is insane. He could back it up. But yeah, damn, that was great. Other than that, of course, we will be watching the Worlds opening ceremony hopefully for all the years. So make sure you like and subscribe. Thank you again for your support. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.